I'm Tracy Baxter with today's Record News Watch. That was a very familiar sound around these parts today as people ventured out to do what had to be done, shovel, snow blow, or plow all that new snow. Reports are anywhere from 16 to 22 inches accumulated during the storm that slammed us during the day and then at night. Meant yet another snow day for schools in the region and for Middletown DPW workers Andrew and Deshaun, meant their day would be spent digging out hundreds of fire hydrants throughout the city.
We got about 700, so a lot of shoveling.
A lot of hydrants, like he said, just make sure we shovel them and make sure there's enough room for them to get through and plug the hoses in, God forbid if anything happens. And yeah, just maintaining that all throughout the city.
By mid-morning, most roads and streets were in generally good shape. The sunshine and milder temperatures were helping melt off much of the slush. By noon, in the town of Wallkill, the time had finally come for weary snowplow drivers to get a badly needed break.
We've had a long couple days, that's for sure. We had our crews come in yesterday morning about 4 a.m. We started with about 35 of our personnel coming in preparing for the storm. The length of the storm, of course, hurt us just from the sheer fact of wearing out our people. We're still working now. We're going to plan on getting everybody out of here about noon today. Our equipment has held up very good due to the tremendous amount of snow that we had. There's areas of the town that we've received over 2 feet of snow. Most of the areas are someplace in the 18 to 22 inch range. So it's a tremendous amount of snow that we haven't seen in this area in a long period of time.
It's all hands on deck here. We bring in water and sewer folks, we bring in parks folks, the golf course employees, everybody is working. Building and grounds employees are working to make sure we take care of the residents and keep the roads open. I think our people did a great job in taking care of the roads. If you're up this morning and you know how much snow we had and you look at the roads, most of them is black pavement, which is amazing.
If you were looking for a silver lining from all of this, you could at least admire the pretty sight of the snow-covered trees in the bright sunshine. Now, sunshine may be hard to come by this weekend. We could get a couple more inches of snow tomorrow. Details coming up in the local forecast. In other news, an 18-year-old from Monticello has been charged with first-degree rape involving a 12-year-old girl. Village police say 18-year-old Desmond Williams was arrested following the incident that happened Tuesday at a residence in Monticello. Williams was additionally charged with endangering the welfare of a child. Monticello school officials were made aware of the incident and notified police. They investigated and then took Williams into custody. He was sent to Sullivan County Jail without bail pending further court action. A woman who worked as an accountant for a Wurtsboro area landscaping business has been charged with stealing $6,500 from the company. 62-year-old Patricia Venuti of Spring Glen was charged with felony grand larceny following a state police investigation. The big snowstorm did not dampen the enthusiasm in the city of Newburgh earlier today, where graduation ceremonies were held, as scheduled, for 13 new firefighters. They will help the city's paid department reach a staffing level unseen since back in the 1970s. The 13 had to pass written and physical exams, then go through training exercises at the Orange County Fire Training Center in New Hampton. Besides battling fires, their duties will also include city code enforcement work. City of Newburgh received an almost $2.5 million federal grant that allowed for the hiring of the new firefighters. Newburgh's fire department manpower dwindled over the years because of financial deficits. And it's not just the mailman who makes his or her appointed rounds in all the heavy snow. So do the flower shop delivery folks, especially on this most important of days, Valentine's Day. At Absolutely Flowers in the town of Wallkill, that meant working the phones, getting flower arrangement orders where they needed to be, and handling in-store customers, all the guys looking for something colorful and pretty for that special someone. Even with yesterday's monster storm and the chaos that caused, store owner Janet Barberio wasn't getting flustered.
This is my favorite day of the year because I love my men. They're the easiest customers in the world to take care of. I love, love, love them. And yes, this is my Super Bowl. I love Valentine's Day.
And we deserve to enjoy at least a part of Valentine's Day after spending all that time shoveling the snow. The word snow is the last thing you want to see in a weekend forecast, but there are a few snow showers predicted for Saturday, and they could amount to another inch or two on top of the mountains of snow yesterday's storm brought us. So Saturday will be cloudy with snow showers and temperatures reaching the mid to upper 30s. Sunday will be cloudy with the highs around 30 degrees. Keep clicking here at Record Online to get the latest post-storm information as well as breaking news throughout the weekend. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Baxter. We'll be right back.